ghostly galleon tossed upon the cloud seas. The rod was a ribbon of moonlight over the purple moor, and the highwayman came riding, riding, riding. The highwayman came riding up to the olden door. He had a French cocked hat on his forehead, a bunch of lace on his chin, a coat of glaring velvet, and breeches of brown doe skin. They fitted with never a wrinkle, his boots were up to the thigh, and he rode with a two-wheel twinkle, his pistol butts a twinkle, his rapier hilt a twinkle under the chilled sky. And all the cobbles they clattered and clashed in the darkened yard, and he tapped with his whip on the shutters, but all was locked and barred. He whistled a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there but the landlord's black-eyed daughter, Bess the landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot into her long black hair. One kiss, my bonny sweetheart, I'm after a prize tonight, but I shall be back with the yellow gold before the morning light. Yet he would press me sharply and hurry me through the day, then look for me by the moonlight, watch for me by the moonlight, I'll come to thee by the moonlight, though hell should bar the way. He rose upright in the stirrups, he scarce could reach a hand, but she loosened her hair in the casement, his face burned like a brand, as a black cascade of perfume came tumbling over his breast, and he kissed its waves in the moonlight, oh sweet waves in the moonlight, he tugged at his rein in the moonlight and galloped away to the west. Gypsy's ribbon looping the purple moor, a redcoat troop came marching, marching, marching. King George's men came marching up to the olden door. They said no word to the landlord, they drank his ale instead, but they gagged his daughter and bound her to the foot of her narrow bed. Two of them to the casement with muskets at the side, there was death at every window, hell at one dark window, for Bess could see through the casement the road he would ride. They tied her up to attention with many a sniggering jest, they had bound a musket beside her with a barrel beneath the breast. Now keep good watch, and they kissed her, she heard the dead man say, look for me by the moonlight, watch for me by the moonlight, I'll come to thee by the moonlight, though hell should bar the way. She twisted her hands behind her with all the knots in her, but she writhed her hands till her fingers were wet with sweat and blood. They stretched and strained in the darkness, and the hours crawled by like years, till now on the stroke of midnight, called on the stroke of midnight, the tip of her finger touched it, the trigger at least was hers. Not at the Toddle on, toddle on in the distance, where they dive, they did not hear. Down the ribbon of moonlight, over the brow of the hill, the highwayman came riding, riding, riding. The redcoats looked to the priming, she stood up straight and still. Toddle out in the frosty silence, toddle out in the echoing night. Nearer came and nearer, her face was like a light. Her eyes grew wide for a moment, she drew in a last deep breath. Then her finger moved in the moonlight, her mask had shattered the moonlight. Shattered her breast in the moonlight, and wound him with a dare. He turned his spur to the west, he did not know she stood. But with her head of a musket, drenched with her own red blood. Not till the dawn he heard it, his face could play to hear. Up as the landlord's daughter, the landlord's black-eyed daughter, had watched for love in the moonlight and died in the darkness there. And back he spurred like a madman, shrieking a curse to the sky, with the white road smoking behind him and his Arabia brandished high. Blood red were the spurs of the golden moon, wine red with his velvet coat. When they shot him down on the highway, down like a dog on the highway, and he lay in his blood on the highway, with a bunch of lace at his throat. Purple moon, the highwayman can.